In July of 2022, I headed towards Albuquerque, New Mexico to do a combination off-road, on-road motorcycle adventure with my friend Steve. I met Steve the prior year during a similar cross-country adventure on the Trans-America Trail. It was his idea to get back together and ride something equally challenging, which was to be a journey from the southern border along the New Mexico-Mexico border of the United States up to the Canada border in Montana. In the first part of this video series, I am heading south from Albuquerque and on my way to meet Steve in El Paso, Texas. Just about out of Albuquerque now. It's hot. It's like 90 degrees, but man, there's so much concrete in the city, big old city blocks, and it was really hot packing my bike up at the shipping warehouse, so I'm glad to be on the move. I got new climb riding gear. It's mesh. I can feel it. It's feeling pretty good. I can't really feel it in the pants though. Maybe if I stand up, I'll get a little breeze through there, but this is Tramway Boulevard. And I feel like I just might have gone through the neighborhood where my sister used to live a long time ago. There's Mount Sandia, or Sandia Mountain. It's the south slope there. I've hiked to the top of that before, camped. And then we actually hiked home to my sister's house, my brother-in-law. I did remember the bike key. That was a good thing. Up here in the little town of Mountain Air, because I noticed that I'd lost the bolt on the side of my helmet that holds the visor down, so I had to go to the hardware store and get something that'll do the trick. Let's see how many miles. 20, like 70 miles. So we're not quite to Gran, Quivira, and then 32 to Pedro Mesa, and then 40 from there to Carrizozo. That car has a paint job like my motorcycle. It looked like a sleet gray Mustang. All right, where the heck am I going? All right, I go left here. So this is a national monument called Gran, see if I can say it right, Quivira, Gran Quivira Ruins, Salinas Pueblo Missions National Monument. Let's check it out.
Thank you. I just stopped in Carrizozo for my first fill up. So I've been 150 miles. I put 2.5 gallons in, so I'm getting about 60 miles per gallon. It's pretty good. According to this, I have 42 miles to Ruidoso and then 60 to Cloudcroft. And some of that is there's a BDR section that I think I'm going to skip, so it may be less than 42 miles. I'll probably cut off about 15 miles. I'd like to save a little bit of time today, and I feel like there'll be plenty of good riding later. I'm just cutting off one little section just because I don't feel like this is the right time to get jiggy with it. So onward to Ruidoso. Himalayan is kind of having a hard time on these hills right here. I'm in third gear, 35 miles an hour, and gotta say it's actually pretty chilly right now. I don't know what the temp is, but this South Carolina boy, he's a little chilly. I'm definitely glad I got those base layers. I have a feeling up in Colorado, Montana, I'll be needing them. So this road from Ruidoso to Cloudcroft was really nice. Especially this last part here through the Lincoln Forest. Sweeping curves, and it smells like cedar trees. It's really cool. Big Daddy's Diner. That's a possibility. I think I'm gonna scope out where my hotel is, and then I'm gonna take a little drive through the downtown and see what the other restaurants look like. All right, here's my hotel right here. Motel, the Dusty Boots. Dusty Boots Cafe. Oh, that's where I'm meant to go, up there. It's a brewery up there, it looks like. Pioneer Village. Here's Brother-in-Law Barbecue. Mad Jack's Barbecue is closed. Here's gas station. 409 unleaded. That's not too bad. Here's the old downtown. Western Bar. Coors. Budweiser. Shinerbach. I agree with all those things. Let's see. Street. Not much happening there. Let me go back and look at that brewery. Heading out of Cloudcroft. Just met a guy in the parking lot this morning on a T7 from Missouri who is doing the BDR south to north. Had a good chat, friendly guy. And I've decided to forego the little like 20 mile section of BDR gravel, and instead I'm taking this highway here called the Sunspot Scenic Byway, which is supposed to be awesome. Thank you. just got stuck in that little town of Timberon. And now this steep winding road, 3 miles. Okay. We'll see. We'll be right back. across a little shelter out here, and I decided to take a little break and look and see. Here's the current situation.
Kind of reminds me of the road to Arco, but with gravel.
Anyway, it's starting to get a little hot. Starting to get hot, and I'm just going to take a little water break and look at the map. I've learned a few things today, and I'll summarize those later, but in short, this is not the right way to go. Now I know. Okay, the time is 5:40, and we're at the El Paso Viva Power Sports Triumph dealership. Steve's been here since 9 a.m. getting tires installed and an oil change and a repair done to, I think, the brake reservoir for the front. He had a reservation, so he thought, but he got here and there was some kind of mix-up, and anyway, it's been a total ordeal. I got here, I think, around 3:30 from all the stuff that happened this morning. A crazy ride to get here. It's hot, and I think Steve's going to ride around the building any minute now, hopefully, and we will get on our way. I mean, we still have 113 miles or something to Deming, New Mexico. Oh, here he comes now. And then I think another like 76 miles.
There he is. It's actually happening.
We are ready.
Actually happening, huh?
I think it's time to roll.
All right. Let's do it.
Looks like we may finally be leaving El Paso. A couple little water sprinkles. You happy to be leaving?
Huh?
Are you happy to be leaving?
Yeah.
Juarez. We are actually on Highway 9 now, basically the lowest highway that follows along the Mexico border of New Mexico at this part of the state. It's going to be dead straight for 58 miles. halfway there.
Dumbo with the floppy ears.
Refreshing lemonade.
Tastes very good.
So I'm going to see if she'll fill my thing with just tap water.
Okay.
33 miles to go to Deming. And it's going to be 8 o'clock when we get there. So we think we're probably going to just take the pavement up to Silver City where our hotel is, because the other route is, some of it is paved roads, but some of it is definitely dirt. And I believe some of that section has sand. It's been a long day, and I don't think we want to try to challenge ourselves doing anything too technical in the dark. So, probably 60 more miles, and then we will call it a day in Silver City.